Well, let's get back to that. The golden rule. Do unto others, and we would have others do unto us. Do we do that? First of all, it doesn't mean do unto others as they actually do unto you. That's easier, to pay people back what they gave us. Now, we have to do what we want them to do, even if they never do it. And it doesn't say do unto others as you would have them do unto you for a while, until you get sick of trying. There's a persistence here that's important. But even more than that, or I guess more unusually than that, is that doing unto others as we want them to do unto us sometimes puts us in uncomfortable positions. Sometimes puts us in a place where we have to tell people things that they don't really want to hear. The way we'd like people to tell us things we don't necessarily want to hear. You know, I think in our hearts, even people who get mad when they're confronted with something, even people who resist on the outside being held accountable, being told, you know, this isn't working, there's a level where they appreciate that. I think all of us would rather that someone talk to us to our face than talk about us behind our back. All of us would rather have an honest assessment from another person, especially a friend, than to know that there's stuff going on that nobody's telling us about. None of us want to be the last to know that people have figured out what we have spinach on our teeth. And remembering talking last week about how lives would be different if we spent the same time caring for our spirit that we spent making sure that our bodies looked presentable before we go out the door in the morning. We want people to come and tell us what we need to hear, even if we don't like it and even if it makes us uncomfortable. And so part of following the word of Jesus is to tell other people things they don't want to hear, even if they don't want to hear it, and even if it makes them uncomfortable. Part of hearing the word that Jesus gives us and then doing it is telling other people things they don't want to hear, is moving outside that comfort zone, is taking a chance to say things that bother the people around us. You know, I've had people come to me and say, this is bugging me. And I know how hard that is. I know that it is very difficult to go to someone, especially someone with a title, and say, you know, this is bugging me. And that step is hearing the word of Jesus and doing it. Talking to people in authority outside this building is part of that. Talking to each other is part of that. Talking to people who aren't part of this church or any church is part of that. You need to do it in love. And the only way you can do it in love is to actually feel love for the person. If someone's really making you mad, you're not going to talk to them in a spirit of love, no matter how much you know you should. You actually have to take the time to get there. But you can get there, and it matters. And so my invitation today, my challenge today, is to look and ask yourself, am I hearing the words that Jesus has spoken? And am I doing them? Now, the word that says go out and speak the truth is far from the only word of Jesus. But back to being Midwesterners, you know, everybody has certain things they need to work on. And even societies or cultures or communities have things we need to work on. And I think as good, respectable Midwestern people, this is something we can work on. Stepping up and saying what needs to be said. Helping people come to understand who they are and what they're being called to do. Speaking the truth, hearing the word of Jesus, and doing. So that's my challenge for this invitation, to take the opportunity to actually do it in the days ahead, to tell someone something they need to hear, even if they don't want it. And with that, let's stand together. Let's sing our invitation song. A reminder that no matter how much we do this, we are always going to have another step. A reminder that Jesus accepts us as we were, and not as we wish we were, just as I am.